My name is Josh Hayes, and my firm and I represent the family of the late Garrett Walker. The family is grieving following this devastating loss. They are asking the same questions the police investigators are asking. What happened, and why did this happen? Andrew and Debbie Walker thank the Tuscaloosa community from the bottom of their hearts for the tremendous outpouring of love and support given to them during this difficult time. In particular, the city of Tuscaloosa, Mayor Walt Maddox, Tuscaloosa Police Chief Brent Blakely, Tuscaloosa Fire and Rescue Chief Randy Smith, Battalion Chief Kevin Burgess, and their entire teams operated with excellence and class as they sought to find Garrett and to bring him home to his parents. A dive team from the Tallapoosa County EMA was also brought in with their specialized sonar equipment and personnel. All of these individuals, every single one, are the true heroes here. Likewise, the University of Alabama community has been tremendous to Garrett's family. From providing lodging and meals to simply being present during the search efforts, the family expresses its heartfelt gratitude. In particular, Dr. Myron Pope and the entire student affairs team, student life, Greek life, student affairs, have all been wonderful to this family, and they deserve our heartfelt thanks. Finally, to Garrett's friends, concern and commitment to returning Garrett home is something the family will simply never forget. The family's message to each of you, fraternity brothers and friends, is this: take care of each other. Take advantage of the counseling sessions being offered by the university, and continue to honor Garrett's legacy by living each day to its fullest and being kind to those in need. As their attorney, I am the liaison in this case between the police and the family. And as such, some of the questions you have, I may not be able to answer, and I may be somewhat limited in what I can say. But with that, I'm happy to take your questions. And I do appreciate each of you coming.
Josh, what does the family need in return?
Well, Kelvin, this is a difficult process, as you all have witnessed. Extremely difficult, a lot of moving parts. They felt like they needed somebody that was looking out for their interest, and they came to us, and we're honored to represent them.
Does the family suspect foul play?
At this time, I'm not able to comment on that. We'll just have to see where the evidence leads. We're certainly encouraging people. If you know anything about that night, Garrett was last seen at 1:15 a.m. early on the morning of November 7th, following the LSU game. If you were around the Gray Lady Bar, if you saw Garrett that night, we ask you that you please come forward and contact the Tuscaloosa Police Department.
What have y'all been able to piece together and figure out about the final few hours before 1:15?
Yeah, Garrett had gone to the football game and had been with some friends, and beyond that, I'm really not able to say. The police are still piecing that together, and certainly we don't want to do anything to get in the way of their investigation.
Josh, the family is still grieving. The funeral is being planned. But going forward now, from your perspective, what do you not know today that you need to know? Specifics, but generally, what does your investigation entail? Everyone knows you have one of the best, most experienced investigators on your team here. What kind of things are you going to be doing and looking for?
Yeah, so Mike, that's a great question. Just anyone who was in the area the night that Garrett went missing, we need to hear from them. If you have information, please reach out. You can reach out to us here at our firm. We'll be sure to get you in touch with the police too. If you saw something, if you think you may have saw something that you're just not sure about, it's kind of the adage, Mike: see something, say something. We need the public to speak up.
Is there
surveillance? Are the Walkers still in town, and if so, what are their immediate plans?
Mm-hmm. The Walker family is not still in town. They were here until sometime this morning, and they've begun their trek back to Maryland with
Garrett's belongings, with Garrett's dog, with Garrett's Jeep. And so you can imagine what they're dealing with today. They're strong people. They're planning the funeral. The funeral will be, I do want to let everybody know, the arrangements are being handled by the Stauffer Funeral Home in Mount Airy, Maryland. That's Stauffer.
Is there surveillance video from the bar showing his last moments before leaving out?
I hope so. I don't know. That's certainly something we have asked that will be preserved. I'm sure the police have too. That's a vitally important piece of evidence.
When will the autopsy results be in?
Yeah, that's a great question. You know, I'm not sure I can give you an idea. Toxicology results in some cases sometimes take a couple of months, so the police would really be in a better spot to say that than me.
Are you able to tell us, Josh, if it was the equipment brought in by the Tallapoosa guys that located Garrett's body?
You know, I really don't know. What I do know is those guys, they hopped into their cars in the middle of the night and got over here as quick as they could. They were in and out of that water for multiple days. It's dangerous work. And they were brave enough to leave their own families to come help this family. I do believe they were vital in finding Garrett, and the family is eternally grateful to those people.
Josh, were you guys told, in relation to where the staging area was at and where us and everybody else was, where did they find Garrett's body in relation to that, if you can't tell?
That's a question for the police, Kelvin. I honestly don't know.
Is a lawsuit being planned in regards to what happened to him before he disappeared and then after?
You know, not yet. I mean, we'll see where the facts lead us on that. It's way too early to be jumping to any kind of speculation like that. We'll see where the evidence leads, where the witnesses lead, what the surveillance camera shows, and, you know, we'll see where the evidence leads us. Certainly anybody who is responsible for Garrett's death, we will seek to hold them accountable.
Who reported him missing?
You know, that's a question for the police. I'm not sure I know that answer.
Do you know whether he was alone at the river, or he went there alone, or do we know any of those things whatsoever?
I'm not at liberty to say that right now.
A GoFundMe was started, and it's my understanding several thousand dollars were accumulated in that account. What happens to it going forward?
Yes, that's a great question too. I'm glad to cover that. The community has been tremendously generous. I just checked before I came out here, and I think it's approaching $50,000 that's been raised. Certainly the family will have some unexpected sudden funeral expenses. After that, you know, it was originally established for a reward. Now that the reward is no longer needed to bring Garrett home safely, the family made the decision to establish what would be called the Garrett Walker Memorial Scholarship.
Josh, you were on scene a good part of both days that the search was going on. Those of us in the media sometimes, and maybe in law, I don't know, get a little hardened to stories. Oh, it's just another thing that we cover. But you were there when his body was found. Have you witnessed raw emotion like you saw last night? It just had to break your heart.
Yeah, Mike, that's one of the roughest days I've been a part of personally in my career. I pray that we at this firm never get callous to the fact that we're dealing with people's lives on their very worst day. But yesterday is unlike anything I've ever seen. Just the sheer heartbreak from the parents laid bare for the world to see, and the fraternity brothers and hundreds, literally, as you saw, of students gathered for days on end. Speaks a lot to our community, I think, Mike, and the university community, and that was a rough day.
Can you speak about Garrett as a person and the son and brother that the Walkers have lost?
I would be honored to do that. I wish I would have known him. He sounded like an amazing young man. At 20 years old, he was already an accomplished pilot. He was studying aerospace engineering to follow in his grandfather's footsteps. His father, his godfather, and his brother are also experienced pilots. Some of the photos I shared with you, and I'll be glad to share them if you don't have them, show just a love of flying among the brotherhood in that family. He was his father's firstborn, and it's just something that is unimaginable that this family is dealing with. Exceptionally bright young man, also talented on the baseball field, had some opportunities to play in college, and wanted to choose academics instead, and was well on his way to making a mark in this world.
You had mentioned the scholarship. going to be created in his name and honor. Can you, and I know it's early, is it going to be to a University of Alabama student, someone, you know, back home in Maryland where he's from, if you happen to know a couple of details?
I think those are all still things being considered by the family, whether it'll be a local alumni chapter there that matches some of what's raised or endowed here. I don't know. Those are all decisions that we'll sit down with the family and help them make good ones. What they were firm about, though, is that, you know, Garrett lived a lot of life in his 20 years, and we do not want him remembered for the way he died. We want him remembered for the way he lived. He was an incredible young man. His parents are very proud of him. His mother said it best that she's going to remember Garrett as a young man of faith. They told a story yesterday of a tattoo on his body that his father wasn't pleased with, but he was pleased with the content of it. It was Joshua 1:9, and that family is going to be special to me going forward for sure.
What's the focus for the police investigation moving forward?
That's a question for the police. We're going to stay out of their way. We intend to be very helpful to them. Like I said, the chief has been amazing. His investigators have been amazing. We want to support them, but we absolutely do not want to get in the way. Again, anyone with any knowledge, please contact the Tuscaloosa Police Department.
Was the family able to provide any context on where he might have been going? Did he have any reason to be around the river? Does he live down this way?
Chelsea, I'm just not able to comment on that right now.
As you go forward, will you be able to talk to us once in a while?
Sure.
Update us? I know nothing about what all you have to do, but it won't just be a silent thing we'll never hear about till the end. You're able to talk to us once in a while.
Right. There are certain ethical rules that would prevent me from saying some things that I might know, but generally, Mike, I do plan on keeping the public informed on this case. I think it's, as we've seen, this community cares a lot about this story, cares a lot about this family, and we want to give them updates as often as we can.
Can you speak to some of the groups and others who work to try to comfort them and help them here in Tuscaloosa over the last couple of days? I know the university apparently did some things, including put them up in a hotel.
Yeah.
And some area churches may have done some things to make sure Garrett's friends and fraternity brothers and that sort of thing were being comforted and taken care of as they sat there and waited with the family.
Yeah, Kelvin, the university was absolutely amazing from the jump on this. They were quick to offer help to the family. They were quick to offer help to the fraternity brothers and friends of Garrett's that you saw piled up on that hill for a couple of days. Student Life even brought out folding chairs and tarps for them to have a place to sit comfortably. There was food provided, coffee, donuts, you know, everything you could hope for to support the student community. I think our university did it, and I'm awful proud to be an alum.
Was his family here for the game, or did they come in after he couldn't find him?
They were not here for the game.
Okay.